Welcome back to Death by Metal. What'd you think of that COC?
Dance of the Dead.
You know, I never heard the song before. You know, the only COC I've ever really been familiar with is their last album, In the Arms of God, and Deliverance, of course. Great fucking album. Good stuff.
Yeah. Well, you know, I want to do some news. It's got to be known that Heaven and Hell, you know, they had their last show of the deal, you know, for Matt Singer. They're going to do a DVD with the concert they did in, at the Bakken Festival in 2009. And it's going to be called Neon Nights. And it also includes interviews, personal tributes, deal. Yeah, so, right on by that. I got to have some of them. Last one of the deal, definitely.
Hell yeah.
That's a must have. And, you know, we were talking about Slayer a little bit, weren't we? We were at our intermission talking about, you know, the level of essential reason to like South of Heaven.
South of Heaven really gets a lot of bad rap. It really does. You know, anything that was going to follow up Rain and Blood, especially if it was going to be different, which they wanted to do something different after Rain and Blood. Anything, it doesn't matter what it was, followed Rain and Blood, was going to be looked down upon. There's no getting around it.
But believe me, that first song, that South of Heaven, was awesome. And that long, drawn-out note at the end of that song, the lead into the second song, is beautiful. I just love that part of the album. You know, you talk about the Mandatory Suicide, that's a great song too.
And you know, Behind the Crooked Cross, and you know, the closer, Spill of Blood, all really great songs.
And my bitch was the fact that it sounded lazy, it just sounded laid back, and you're right, it just slowed down Slayer, and it just, at the time, I didn't care, it was Slayer. And everyone was gonna play it anyway, because they were the hot band.
Right.
Especially after Rain of Blood, it just killed everybody. They just wanted some more Slayer after that. But when it came out of that, it just, at the time, I played that shit out. I played it all the time. And at the time, I didn't care at the time what it was that I was listening to. It was Slayer. And at the time, it rules. And it is definitely an essential album. But looking in retrospect, I see it as being a lazy album. Looking at when they came out with Seasons, they really wanted to do that album before South Heaven, but that's fine. And that's cool with me.
Well, they did state later on that when they did Seasons and did this, that it was the album that South of Heaven should have been. That's what they were aiming for, and so basically, I guess, South of Heaven was the footer, and Seasons and this was the perfection.
Mm-hmm. Definitely.
And I definitely agree with that, because that's my favorite Slayer album.
So let's get on a different subject. Let's talk about the Dream Theater's drama lately.
Mike Portnoy left the band.
Yeah.
And he said he just needed a break. And the split was peaceful, amicable. Everybody was cool with it. And then, of course, you know, media people want to be on their ass and then ask them about this stuff nonstop. So James LaRee made a comment, something about he was not, you know, upset about Mike's departure in the band. So, it got misconstrued, I guess, especially when it got back to Portnoy. I mean, and especially when you're looking at Blabbermouth, because Blabbermouth, any interview, any news piece that they post, they look for the most controversial thing they can to make the headline.
Right.
And that was it, you know, this James LaRee not I can't remember what it was exactly, something about it. He wasn't sorrowful that Mike had left the band or whatever. And of course, Portnoy took it just way beyond what James LaFrie ever meant by it. And it just kind of blew up from there. So of course, next interview with LaFrie, he was saying, well, you know, I wasn't trying to be, you know, insensitive or whatever. I'm just saying, you know, we've got it covered. We're not going to falter because Mike is gone. We can handle it. You know, because, of course, Mike was the spokesperson for the band. He did everything for Dream Theater. Mm-hmm. But, you know, everybody apparently is stepping up to take his place, talking with the fans and everything, so.
And apparently they already have a drummer lined up for the next one, whenever that comes out. What kills me is the fact that, you know, James can go on and do this solo project, which I'm going to talk about now a little bit. His new album.
Static Impulse.
His longtime songwriting partner, Matt Gilroy. Peter Wildur, the Arcane, is the drummer on the album. He does all the screams on it.
Yep.
And Marco Stigley on guitar, and Ray Halford on guitar player. I can't remember his name. Redual. But, you know, it's something to look forward to. I mean, I'll listen to it. I mean, I'll listen to it. He told me it's half and half.
Yeah, I mean, it's not bad. I heard it. It's some of it's okay and some of it kind of sucks, you know.
I heard one video on it. From what I heard, it was okay. I want old James. But right now, I want to do my next classic. And I'm telling you, this is one of my all-time classics. Probably the all-time classics. This is a band called Carcass. This is an album called Heartwork. Essential.
Definitely.
Band. No doubt about it. If you talk about a band that was legendary and just pure influential in our music today, this is Carcass. And I call them Crackass now. I'm so used to them, you know. Crackass. Yeah, that's my Crackass. Hell yeah. I mean, that was, you know, the band of my life. You know, they dominated my 90s. I seen them one time with Napalm Death, a Deed Bowl, and I can't remember the other band. It was a two-night bill that I seen at the old Club 367. And the first night was Crackass and Napalm. And then the second night we had Obituary headline with Cannibal Corpse was there with Chris Barnes. And that was, you know, probably one of those real special two nights I ever had. On Monday and Tuesday too, that was so cool about it. Start of the week show. I fell in love with Carcass in those days. The Necroticism album, that was the album that really just transformed me into a true sick man. But this album here,
like,
it's kind of more of the mainstream approach to get popular, and it definitely did the truth. And I'm going to do the title track on this album. It rules. This is Heartwork. Carcass. Death by Metal.